हेलो ज्ञान स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सोशल साइंस क्लास अबाउट राइज ऑफ जैनिज्म एंड बुद्धिज्म। इन दिस चैप्टर चिल्ड्रन यू आर ऑल गोइंग टू स्टडी द लर्निंग पॉइंट्स आर बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द राइज ऑफ जैनिज्म एंड बुद्धिज्म, इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट जैनिज्म एंड बुद्धिज्म। इंडिया इज ए लैंड ऑफ मेनी कल्चर्स एंड रिलीजियंस। दिस डाइवर्स कल्चर इज नरिश्ड बाय वेरियस रिलीजियंस। ऑफ दिस The Jainism and Buddhism are the two important religions. They emerged during 6th century BCE in the mid region of River Ganga plains. By the time of 6th BCE, Indian society was divided on the basis of varnas. All the four varnas had emerged clearly. In the first two varnas, Brahmin and Kshatriya were there, and below them were Vaishya and Shudra. The religions of Buddha and Mahavira identified the desire as the main reason for all the human hardships. Let us learn one by one. First one is Jainism. Jainism is one of the very ancient religions. Rishabha was the first Tirthankara, whereas Parshvanatha was the 23rd Tirthankara. Parshvanatha was born as the son of King Ashwasena in the 8th century BCE. It is believed that he renounced all luxury and indulgence and attained immortality. He renounced society and became a hermit. He preached four principles for a peaceful life. They are non-violence, truth, asteya, and aparigraha. The fifth principle of brahmacharya was taught by Vardhamana. He was the 24th Tirthankara. Let us learn life of Vardhamana Mahavira. Vardhamana was born in Kundala Grama in Vaishali, one of the republics. His father was Siddhartha, the king of the Gnatrika tribe. His mother was Trishala Devi, the princess of the Republic of Lichavi. At the age of 30, Vardhamana set out in search of truth and renounced his family and house. He wandered for 12 years in this quest and meditated. He punished his body by fasting. At the age of 42, he achieved enlightenment. Vardhamana controlled his senses and achieved power over comfort and pain. Due to this achievement, he came to be known as Mahavir and became Jina. A Jina was one who had overcome his senses and become victorious. Thus, his followers came to be called Jains. Mahavira spent 30 years of his life preaching his knowledge to the people. At last, he attained Nirvana in his 72nd year in Pavapuriya, Bihar. Mahavira taught 5 O's. They are non-violence, truth, asteya, aparigraha and brahmacharya. And the three principles are samyaknan, samyak darshan, samyak charitra. Later, they are all called triratnas. Jains believe that it is only through purification of the soul that one can achieve freedom from rebirth and attain nirvana. Traditionally, we get to see two important sects among Jains called Shvetambaras and Digambaras. Those saints and their followers who wear white cloths are called Shvetambaras, whereas those saints and their followers who do not wear any clothes are called Digambaras. Very early, a group of Jains migrated to the south due to the famine in Bihar and settled down at Shravanabelagola. Thus, even here, Jainism spread and many works were written in Kannada, Telugu and Tamil languages. The famous Kannada poets Pampa, Ranna, Janna and Ponnavar Jains. Now let us view Buddhism. The religion founded by Gautama Buddha was Buddhism. It was established about 2500 years ago. Gautama was born in Lumbini near Kapilavastu of Nepal. His childhood name was Siddhartha. His father Suddhodana was the king of the Republic of Shakya. Renouncing kingly luxury and familiar happiness, Siddhartha became a hermit, disillusioned with the prevailing ways of life. Attaining enlightenment, he became Buddha. After becoming Buddha, the enlightened one, he first went to Saranath near Banaras. There in the deer park, he gave his first sermon. This has been called Dharma Chakra Pravartana. Here he preached the Four Noble Truths and the Eightfold Path. The basic teachings of Buddha are known as Four Noble Truths. World is full of sorrow. Desire is the root of sorrow. Conquering desire is the way out of sorrow. Ashtanga Marga is the path to end sorrow. The Eightfold Paths are action, speech, vision, livelihood, effort, recollection, resolve, and thought. In the 80th year, Buddha's glorious life of selfless service came to an end at Kushinagar. This has been called Mahaparinirvana. After Buddha's death, his followers collected his teachings and tradition in the form of Tripitakas. These are Vinaya, Dhamma, and Abhidhamma Pitakas.
Thank you for all watching the video. If you really liked our video, click on the like button, share, and do subscribe. From Gnanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.gnanajyoti.in.